mark that as well. C for calcium, M for magnesium, A for aluminium, Z zinc, I iron, like or L lead, H hydrogen, C again copper, M mercury, S silver, G gold. Then comes platinum, which you can write. The last one is platinum, always remember. Alright, so potassium, so I'll write the symbols as well. K, N, A, C, A, M, G, A, L, Z, N, F, E, P, B, H, C, U, A, G, H, G, A, U. And then P, T. Alright, so that's the reactivity order. So every element before hydrogen can displace hydrogen. Every element after hydrogen cannot displace. Also, you should remember one thing here, that is copper cannot react with HCl, but it can react with concentrated H2SO4 and concentrated HNO3. Why? Because these two act as oxidizing agents. Sorry. So if they are acting as oxidizing agents, they can reduce themselves and react with copper by oxidizing copper. Each, the one that can displace will be from here, the one which cannot displace will be from here. Alright, so the next question is, in the electrolytic refining of a metal M, what would you take as anode, cathode and electrolyte? Now again, I'll be telling you the answer to this question first, and after that I am going to take an example and also explain that. That is important for your board questions. So I'll teach that as well. Alright, so answer to this will be, now because M, we are going to refine that. So that is impure in state. Refining to usi ki karenge na jo pure nahi hai. So the one which has to be taken as anode is always impure, because anode starts shedding impurities in the form of anode mud. Mud matlab impurity. Anode mud matlab anode ki impurity. So impurity kaha se aayegi? Anode se. Alright. So anode will be M. So obviously, if anode is M, which is the impure metal, this is the impure metal, right? So cathode will be the opposite, or we will say pure metal, right? And that should be of the same form. Okay? Then electrolyte will be salt of pure metal M. Matlab, it's not M, the impure one, but M, example copper impure hai. So copper sulfate we will use. If it is something else, if there is Na, impure, so we will take NaCl electrolyte. Getting it? So here, it can be MSO4, MCl, anything. Alright, write down the answers and I'll tell you one example, which is important as per your board questions. Alright, so we will take copper refining, copper's electrolytic refining. In this case, what do we do is, we take an electrolytic cell where we have impure, okay, this impure copper has come from various processes. Alright, it is already extracted from its ore, that is copper sulfide, which is also called as copper glands. Alright, so the after roasting and everything, you get this impure copper, you get copper which is not completely pure. So we need to do the last step, refining, right? And that refining, because there are some impurities which are adhered or stuck in a way that cannot be removed by using any reduction process. Reduction as in not electrolytic, the simple reduction process, or by using some reducing agent. So the last step, where all these agents do not help, we have to go for electrolytic reduction. Alright, or here we will call this electrolytic refining, because it is the last stage refining process. Alright, and then, so you have impure copper which is taken as, see, that is connected to the long line, that means the positive terminal of the battery. So that is impure copper anode. Anode is connected always to positive terminal. And cathode is connected to the negative terminal. So cathode is the pure copper strip. Label it properly. Impure copper is anode. Into brackets, write down anode. Pure copper is cathode. Why? Because it is attached to negative terminal. Negative terminal se hamesha cathode attached hota hai. Positive terminal se hamesha anode. And as I told you, in refining we take the same metal salt. So here we are taking copper sulfate, and that too we are going to take acidified copper sulfate. Why acidified copper sulfate? Because it ionizes more. Fir se is pe dhyan dijiye, because you will get a question on this also. You can get, you may get a question as, why do we take acidified copper sulfate? Because it ionizes more. So, here we will write acidified CuSO4. Why is acidified copper sulfate used? Because copper sulfate will not break that easily, and by adding a little acid, it breaks up very easily. Alright, then pure copper acts like cathode. Impure copper acts like anode. Electrolyte is nothing but the same salt, same metal salt. Now, how does this work? Now, anode, as the electricity is passed through the circuit or the electrolytic cell, anode will start shedding some impurities. Now, there will be two types of impurities. One, soluble, and the other will be insoluble impurities. All the insoluble impurities will start depositing below anode. So, how can you remember this thing? See, it is coming out of anode. So, the name also has anode mud in it. Anode in it. Right? And because it is impurity. So, impurity is given the name as mud. Right? So, this is nothing but anode mud. So, where is anode mud found? It is deposited below anode. Now, because this is anode, so on anode oxidation takes place. Always remember, an ox, red cat. That means on anode oxidation occurs, on cathode reduction occurs. Oxidation ka matlab loss of electron, and reduction ka matlab gain of electron. Now, this copper is in Cu form with no charge. This copper is in Cu2 plus form. So, oxidation ho gaya, that means loss of electron. If this one loses two electrons, that is oxidation taking place, this will what it do? What will it do? it will accept those two electrons, and hence the acceptance of two electrons over here is called as reduction or gain of electrons. That is the cathode activity, right? So two electrons lost from here will be taken up by cathode, which is in Cu2+2. Now the next important part over here is we have to write the cathode and anode reactions. Reaction, RXN is reaction. Reaction at anode will be, what is anode doing? Copper is losing two electrons. So can I write like this? Cu minus two electrons, and as two electrons are going out, what charge will be bear by it? Plus, right? So two electrons out, two plus. Cu, two plus. But this is not the correct way of writing. Now tell me, if this changes its side, that means if it goes there, what sign should I write there? Plus. Minus 2, plus. So the reaction will be Cu giving out 2 plus 2 electrons and forming Cu2+. So this is what you have to write. This is the anodic reaction. Now, reaction at cathode. Reaction at cathode will be, this is in Cu2+ form. And what is it doing? It is accepting two electrons. So it is balancing the charge, and 2 plus 2 minus 0. So overall charge on Cu will be 0. I need not write that. So these two are cathodic and anodic reactions. You can write the states. No, there is no need over here. So that's all this electrolytic refining of copper. First you take the impure copper as anode and pure copper strip, which is a thin copper strip. So thin and thick. This one is thin. That one is thick. Because it has a lot of impurities attached to it. And then you take the same metal salt, which should be acidified. Why do we usually take acidified salts, acidified compounds in the electrolytic processes? So that it breaks up easily. Same case over here, acidified CuSO4, because so that it should ionize properly. Then as the electrolytic reduction starts, electrons from anode starts traveling towards cathode. That means anode, on the anode, oxidation starts taking place. Oxidation means loss of electrons. So copper starts losing electrons, and the lost electrons are accepted by cathode. Because on cathode, reduction takes place, and reduction means gain of electrons. So you will write these reactions for that, right? This one and not this one, because this is the scientific way. This is for your understanding, because copper losing two electrons matlab copper minus two electron. Next, the impure copper will have two types of solubility. Two types of impurities, soluble impurities and insoluble impurities. Soluble impurities will go in the solution, where they will be soluble in the electrolyte. Insoluble impurities will start depositing below the anode itself and will be called as anode mud. Why anode mud? Mud because impurity, anode because it is coming out of anode. That's it. Copy this down. The ninth question is sulfur powder. I have done the question, I'm sure. This is sulfur powder. Pratyush took sulfur powder on a spatula and heated it. Then he collected the gas by gas evolved by keeping an inverted test tube over it. And you have to answer the questions related to the condition given. So what will happen? Now obviously, Here there is sulfur powder kept, which is being heated, and when it starts heating, it starts evolving some gas. Now we have to answer according to all this. Now the gas evolved, when it is tested over a litmus paper, what will happen? If it is dry litmus paper, the gas will not show any action on dry litmus paper. Why? Because there are no ions in the dry litmus paper, or there will be no ionization of the gas. So simply here I will write nothing, or simply we will write no change. No change on the litmus paper. Now second one, moist litmus paper. Because it is moist, so there will be ionization, and if there are ions present, now it will show the change on litmus paper. Which gas will be produced? That is sulfur. Heated in the presence of oxygen only, obviously. So it is being burned or heated there. When it is happening in open, we always write in oxygen. Okay, S plus O2, it will give SO2. Write the states. This will be gas that is evolved. This is again gas, and this is solid sulfur powder. Alright. So the sulfur dioxide produced, now it is a non-metal. Non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Why? Because it is non-metallic. Now non-metallic oxides, because they are acidic in nature, so on moist litmus paper, what will happen? Blue litmus will turn red. Red will stay red only. So blue litmus paper will turn red. Also write why? Because SO2, being a non-metallic oxide, is acidic in nature. B part is write the balanced chemical equation for the reaction that is occurring. Here it is. Sulfur in the presence of oxygen being heated. We will show a triangle on the arrow because it is being heated. It is giving SO2. That's it. It is balanced because we have 1s both the sides. We have 2 oxygens both the sides. Tenth question. State 2 ways of preventing rusting of iron. Very easy. You can write, there are many. You can write any 2 of them. We will write galvanization. What is galvanization? Galvanization is coating of zinc over iron. And second, you can write alloying. You can also write painting, but alloying will be better. So what is alloying? You know that mixing another metal or a non-metal to a metal to strengthen it and also to prevent it from corrosion. So I'll write 2 methods. 2 methods will be if you want to write what are these 2, you can write down. Alloying is addition of carbon or nickel and chrome, nickel and chromium to iron to make it corrosion proof. Second, for galvanization, you will write galvanization is coating of zinc over iron. The question is, what type of oxides are formed when non-metals combine with oxygen? We just discussed it in the 9th question. Non-metallic oxides are acidic oxides. So we can give an example to prove this one. Example, carbon is a non-metal. Carbon with oxygen will form CO2, and that CO2 when combined with water forms H2CO3, which is nothing but carbonic acid. You can give such an example for sulfur. SO2 plus H2O will give you H2SO3. that is sulfurous acid. Same way you can give for NO2 as well. Alright, so and then you will write H2CO3 will turn blue litmus red. That will be the confirmatory test. Now next, question number 12. For all these are reasoning questions. First one is, platinum, gold and silver are used to make jewelry. Why? Obviously because they are least reactive, so they can be useful as making jewelry, so that the jewelry doesn't corrode and it doesn't harm our skin. Because to make jewelry, we need metals that do not react with our skin. Because PT, AU, AG are very, very less reactive. Hence, they are suitable. They won't harm our skin or would not react with the skin or anything, or they would not even react with the environmental factors, and then they will not get corroded and they will not lose their shine. They don't lose their luster. Second is, sodium, potassium, lithium are stored in oil, obviously because they are highly reactive. If they are exposed to oxygen or even moisture, they start reacting vigorously. Because NaKLi are highly reactive metals, and if exposed to air or moisture, they start reacting vigorously. These metals catch fire in water. Next, the C part is, aluminium is highly reactive, yet it is used to make utensils for cooking. Why? Aluminium is used to make utensils for cooking because aluminium has a property to form aluminium oxide. When it comes in contact of air, first thing it does is it forms Al2O3, which is the aluminium oxide, acts as a protecting layer, and it also prevents further corrosion. Aluminium forms thin layer of aluminium oxide on its surface, which prevents further corrosion. And acts as a protective layer. Next is carbonate. This is the short form for carbonate. Carbonate and sulfide. Sulfide, S-U-L-P-H. Ores are usually converted to oxides during extraction process. Now this is very interesting. Even for calcination or roasting, the first step that we do is we convert them to oxides. Now why? Because as they are CaCO3 or ZnCO3 or Cu2S, as they are, from that we cannot simply get rid of that S or CO3. We cannot simply get rid of that. So to remove that part, first we need to convert it to oxide form. So if I have ZnO or CuO, now I can reduce it easily. Reduce means reduction. Reduction is nothing but removal of oxygen. And for removal of oxygen, we have many reducing agents, right? By using any reducing agent, or by, in some cases, by just using heat, we can get rid of that oxygen, right? So why is it so? Because it is easier to reduce the oxide form than that of carbonate or sulfide by the help of reducing agent or heat. So answer to this will be it is easier or convenient to reduce oxide form than that of simply I can write we need not write all of this, we shall only write it is easier to reduce oxide form using reducing agents or heat only in very less reactive metals case.